What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. It's scorching hot today. I'm actually underneath these pines here to get out of the sun because it's hot. But we're gonna set up a ground blind today overlooking what's going to be a little kill plot of some brassicas and some clover. And I think that'll be about it in that. But this ground blind in this spot goes here every year. I put it in the same spot. And I'm gonna take you through step by step on how I set it up and how I brush it in, because brushing it in and where it's located is very important points in being successful when you're ground blind hunting. Location first is, it's in this little patch. Probably it's only about 30 yards wide, 30 yards long of pines. And it's just a little patch. There's a little strip of some grasses over here, then it's the woods. Over here is, I got a strip of Egyptian wheat. Behind that is a 3-acre food plot. So I can slip down the fire road. I can walk through this little path I have cut out through these pines. I can slip right into the backside of this food plot. The kill plot is over here. I've actually got in this ground blind with deer in that plot, and I'm only 5 yards off the food plot. And it's perfect because I have a pine here and a little pine here, and a ground blind fits perfect right behind that. I can actually use these pines to just help secure it down with some paracord. And in front of it, I got a little brush pile, and just kind of helps blend it in a little bit. But it's a very good spot because back over here, goes back through the woods, through a travel corridor, down through a ditch, up a ditch, and then just head straight back to a bedding area that I've cut. And I also have a tree stand about halfway back for morning hunts. This here will be more of an afternoon sit. Deer coming out of that, heading toward the food plot, and then they can hit this plot and then head out to the main field. So it's a good setup. And first things first, guys, is when doing this, is you have to pick the location to where you can get in and out of. So then next step would be, I have a little garden rake here that I picked up at Home Depot. Just a cheap one. It's made by Ames, and I think it costs like $8, but it's cheap. And the first step you want to do is always rake out the ground area where you're going to be hunting, because ground blinds are open in the bottom. So when you're in there, you don't want to be, you know, stepping on leaves, crunching leaves and stuff. You just want that bare soil, so you're not making any noise. So we just take the rake and, you know, rake all that bottom out. Here, there's no leaves, it's just pine needles, which I'll just rake that out anyway. Get those pine needles out, that way when you get in there in the morning, it's nice and quiet. Then just take the ground blind, and you will just want to unfold it. And once you have it unfolded, fold out the sides and then the top, and or the top and the sides, and then set it in place. And then obviously you want to use whatever anchors that it came with. Secure each corner with the anchors. And then sometimes too, what I like to do is, once you have that set in place, to take some dirt and kind of push it up on the sides. One main reason is just so scent has less chance of getting out of that blind. You can kind of contain everything, even though, you know, when we're hunting it, we're gonna have the wind blowing this way, you know, back up through here, because I don't really predict any deer coming from this way. Obviously, I don't want it blowing that way or this way. And definitely not that way. But if we have a good wind, and we can hunt this spot. So just throw some dirt up on that side, and you'll be good to go in that aspect. And once you have this in place, I always like to leave the windows open that I plan on shooting out of. So I'm leaving all the windows open on the front side. That way, when it's time to hunt, you're not unzipping the windows, and it looks different. It always, when you leave the windows open, just like you're going to hunt it, there's no change other than you in there. But most times it's, you know, faded out. You can't really see in there. And if you're wearing a black hoodie or black jacket or something and a face mask, you blend right in. I mean, the deer really aren't going to notice a difference. Another key with this is, and getting this set up way before hunting season. I think we're 6 weeks away. And normally I would do it about 4 weeks in advance, but you know, we're here doing a bunch of work and I want to get it in today. It's not going to hurt nothing. And once you have this blind in place, it's secure to the ground, good location, you know, we're going to use pine branches I have to go through. And it's funny because over the years I've cut a lot of these branches, so I have to kind of venture out a little bit to get fresh green ones, because I want the green ones, because this is what here, we have all pines and everything's green, and the pines stay, you know, green all year long. Cedars, pines, and, you know, spruces and things like that, it all stays green. And we're going to use those branches and we're going to drape that over the blind and then cut our holes in. It's a little bit of a process, but you have to take the extra time to make sure it's blended in properly. That way you can hunt it and have a good hunt and not be detected. So I went to the hardware store. I'm actually upset because they didn't have any color but white. But I use, this is not paracord, some junk rope that I bought there. And I could have got paracord a lot cheaper somewhere else, but that's what happens when you go to the hardware store. We're gonna take this and I actually drape this over the blind, kind of like make a circle and drape that over the top side of it. And what that does is it leaves like a hanger, so you can hang these branches, take a branch and just slip it behind. That way the branch just hangs there and you don't really have to do anything else with it. I may take another piece and run it over just so in case the wind blows or something, it doesn't blow them off. And once you get those cedars on there, you just want to cover that thing all the way up as much as you can. Leave your door open, obviously, and the backside you don't have to worry about, because hopefully there's no deer that's going to come back through here to see you on the backside, which I've never had that issue. It can happen if you're not set up on a hard backside or something where deer can slip up from behind you. But I predict the deer to come out from the side and over here with some other bedding areas off to the side there. And once you drape those over, you just take some snips and pruning shears or whatever and just cut the windows out. And once you have those windows cut out, you're pretty much done. I have a little seat back here that I'm going to set in there. That way everything's in there. I'm done with it. Ain't got to worry about it. Come hunting season, I can hunt it. And, you know, it's not a blind that I hunt religiously. It's just another stand location that is an option. You know, you got to have options on your property. And, you know, today we actually hung five stands, three of those, which were new locations. And I think now I have like 9 or 10 stands locations. And will I hunt all 9 of them? Probably not. But if there's a deer, a buck or something that's in that area coming past those stands, then I'm going to hunt it. But you got to have the options for it. And I have cell cams in those areas where, you know, if I am getting something going past there, you know, it's a good option. I remember sitting here in this ground blind during a rut last year. I think it was November 3rd or 4th. And coming out of this travel corridor here, I'm only 20 yards away, but there's pines there, so you can't really see in. Them deer, them bucks just come right out of there. They come right through the corner of this kill plot, and they just sit there, they mill around a little bit, and then they go out into that bigger field, and they're scent checking through there, looking for them does and everything, and they never knew I was here. I was getting in it one morning, and I was getting set up, banging around, you know, and I heard something, like breathing, like panting, and I look up real quick, and there's like a four-pointer or a spike or something. I mean, he was like 5 yards from the blind, just, you know, he was panting and breathing just from probably chasing all night long or, you know, on the search for a doe. But it's pretty cool. Ground blind hunting has changed, you know, my way of hunting. I love ground blind hunting. It's not my preferred method. I'd rather just hunt in a tree stand, but I like this setup. There's no trees around here to where I could set a tree stand in. And ground blind for this location is optimal situation. And you guys can have success with it too. Just take your time and follow the proper steps that I just outlined, and try to use those cedars because they stay green year round, and you'll have good success with it. And I'm excited to get in here and whatever it is, 7, 8, 9 weeks, maybe hunt the rut a couple of afternoons, or, you know, we'll have to see what the cameras tell us and what we're seeing out when I'm out here hunting. But any questions, leave them down below in the comment section. Give the video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you guys are new. It's much appreciated. And I'll see you on the next video.